Hey, what is up, guys? Gonna be playing some of them Ying dragons over here. We got the opener that makes this deck so much stronger. I love this. This is definitely where it's at. Oh man, his deck's pretty fast too. He's got that upstart goblin, but that is so generous of him to heal me up. Oh my gosh, sir, did you upstart into upstart? I love when my opponents do that. I really don't like upstart goblin anymore. Against certain matchups. I mean, if you're playing Bujins, yeah, you probably wouldn't care. Oh, don't tell me you're playing Bujins. Oh, it's the Fire Fist. Alright, let me see what this deck can do. I haven't seen this deck see any play in a long time. At least a pure Fire Fist deck. Might be the hat version. He's got that Leopard. We're gonna go for that, that Tensu. Now, I really like this deck against that deck. This is a pretty good matchup, I would say. Unless, of course, like I say, he's playing some, like, hats or something, like, different. Different version. Yeah, of course, you can Tensu, Normal Summon Spirit, grab the Leopard, he's gonna, yeah, it's cool, I got you, I know you're played, man, I see everything. What? Why didn't you go for Leopard? Or, what is it? Spirit, alright, anyways, let's go ahead and get started with that young duality, and, hopefully we get something good off of it. Or like another duality. No, the reason why I play duality, I've opened up with no monsters sometimes in this deck, and I just don't like that. He's got back row, and I don't want to get warning, so I'm gonna go with that supply unit. I need that mad draw power. We're going crazy over here with that draw power. I love this card so much. It eats MSTs, because people are like, no, I don't want to deal with that card. It gets too much free advantage, and then you just work off that free advantage. And it's not like he's gonna black row, so I mean, I can set wiretap safely over here. And I'd rather just keep lands in my hand anyways. I'm actually okay with pretty much losing everything that I've actually set. Minus, I would prefer not to lose the cosmic dragon over here. I don't know. Well, if I set too many, maybe he'll like end phase decree. Then I'd be like, oh, it's cool. I play like wire. Oh no, actually, I play Call of the Haunted in here. Actually, no, I play Torrential Compulse Warning, like the standard trap lineup. I would say that most decks play. Oh no, he's going for that tank. Is that tanky bear pop? Because I'm gonna get some free advantage off that, which is definitely nice. And let's see if he goes Tanky Bear Pop. He doesn't know what I'm playing yet. Wait, hold on, wait. What did I reveal? Duality? No, I revealed Suni. He's not gonna do it. A Wolf Bar. Okay. But yeah, like I said, like, a Black Rose play, it wouldn't even be that strong for him. I wouldn't even really care too much. Because, like, I still get my free card. Oh, he's going for that Gorilla. Oh, no. No, I don't want him to pop. Oh, no, what are you gonna pop? Pop this one. Pop the wiretap. I don't care about that. Oh, okay, cool. I got a lance to protect my monster, and the only thing that basically stops lance is like a warning. That's pretty much it. Like, I know I reduced my monster. Like, the only thing that will suck is warning, because remember, guys, it's unaffected by trap cards because of the effect of the Bixie. Let's get rid of that thing. Get that out of here. All right, now let's go ahead and finish off the game. And it gains 500 attack. That is too dirty, and he says GG. That was a pretty good game. I mean, he was able to get a bunch of his stuff, but you can see that Cosmic Dragons, man, the sustain that they have is just too strong. Plus, the guy was a gentleman, and he'll be up for an extra 2,000 life points. But anyways, thanks for watching, guys. Have a great day. Ish Nice out.